Long ago I have ceased to compose on my own. My demands on the artwork increased so much, and the world today is so complex that I rely on help. One should use any technical and human resource, because otherwise that would only mean to create artificial problems. Just as I need an instrumental ensemble for the performance, I also employ a legion of labor already for the composition process. There is way too much I am not able to do, and which would limit me otherwise. Only this arsenal of options allows me the nowadays necessary mastering of material and flexibility. First of all, there is market research. My research team visits festivals, is listening to radio broadcasts. Also, they go to art exhibitions and theater premieres. But above all, they surf through the internet to podcasts and music blogs worldwide, looking for the latest trends and techniques and well, for the zeitgeist. And furthermore, Facebook surveys are conducted, ideas are tested with subjects, high-performance computers identify statistical trends, and they evaluate aesthetics. This is not to find the formula for the perfect piece, but it's simply to understand the modern world. Secondly, a creative team develops ideas. I mean, originality is mandatory, and all kinds of creative composing techniques like brainwriting, Edison principle, headstand technique, mind mapping, gallery methods, KJ methods, dissociation, coincidence technique, Tillmark methods, and so on and so forth, they may be used. We have different local facilities, one for rhythm, one for pitch, one for noise. Over 1,000 people are working only on form. A special office is solely responsible for finding the titles and program texts, and the background philosophies are developed in a think tank in Connecticut, from where I also get my written lectures. Third, a subcontractor of software and hardware developers remains on the cutting edge of audio technology. They buy licenses of foreign technologies. Well, perhaps they also operate industrial espionage. I leave that to them. And they develop software and equipment for me. Fourth, the executive company writes the score and they create the electronics. I am almost never present there, which is just the best thing to do. Well, I think they really don't want to see me over there. I would rather worsen the product. But a detective makes the audit. I usually hear the piece for the first time in the concert. Anyway, the majority of the work is done by machine intelligence. For a long time, none of this would be feasible only by human hands and brain. And I am the boss of the whole. I coordinate everything, and at the end, I take the responsibility. I'm making the brand, I'm giving my name. I'm the public person of the whole, I'm available for interviews, and I'm representing the factory in concerts and at the parties. Well, don't make, there's no doubt about that, the art production is dictatorial. There might be something like swarm intelligence, but there's no art communism. In art, it takes many hands and minds, but it needs a mastermind who holds it all together, who keeps the motivation, who pays, and who first of all finds the right people. I'm describing this because it's about to practice which something which is or it's simply to practice what is to practice it as aware as possible, which subcutaneously is a principle that happens anyway. This should all be put into effect. Anyway, such a division of labor is in practice since ages in the visual arts. Look at Peter Paul Rubens, his studio already was a factory. It is definitely not about making money. That's in new music almost impossible. In fact, the production costs are much, much higher than the income from the work of art. So acquisition, fundraising and lobbying are at the very beginning of the production plan. It is about creating a hyper-modern work of art. Very occasionally, I feel the sort of sentimental desire to compose personally. Then I sign as an ordinary laborer on another composer company. I usually do not even know who I work for then. Once I did, and years later, by chance, I recognized a piece in a concert where I have a modest share. Another time, it revealed at some point that it is a supplier of my own company where I was working for. I noticed it because it was a typical scandal strategy which was staged and which I really disliked, so then I discharged. Later I read in the newspaper that the piece was a huge success. Now, the global market for new music is divided into four trusts. One more orientated to classical music, one more playful, one strictly conceptual, and the fourth has more an abstract program. And of which, after all, one has my name. Unsightly patient litigations and antitrust proceedings, however, overshadow the art world. Meanwhile, I am lonely, and let not even look at me. Once I had the desire to write again on a sheet of music, which is plenty ridiculous. I mean, that would be like if I wanted to build a car by hand, which I then wanted to compete with Mercedes and Porsche. At the moment, my group releases a text in which they want to make a mythological figure out of me. It lifts me to an unknown size in the whole process. No one knows what I am actually doing in the whole, who I am, and it is even unknown if I am a real person at all. I feel unable to disclaim.